It's board season. Lots of people have been asking me how I studied for my boards and if I have any tips on how to pass the National Dental Hygiene boards. So, although I've tried to delete these dark memories from my mind, I'm going to take a journey back and try to give you some tips and tricks and tell you kind of how I studied for boards and how I passed. This book was my Bible. This is actually the newer version. This is from Dental Hygiene Seminars. And here, let me get my older one. This was mine. This was mine from 5 years ago. The book, you know, updates, it changes. Anyway, it's from Dental Hygiene Seminars, a board review course. And this is what I took. My whole class, we went together and we took this seminar. So of course, I would recommend everyone, if you're studying for boards and trying to figure out what to do, I would recommend everyone to take Dental Hygiene Seminars board review. Not only do you get this book, but attending a seminar in person with highly educated speakers in person. They told me exactly what to highlight and what to know in every chapter. That was everything for me. It was a whole weekend of refreshing everything you know and everything you need to know. And then they also provided you with like study tips, and they gave you solid information about the format of the test itself. It was a 3-day weekend of different speakers talking about different subjects, and it's super organized. So say on like day one, you start in the morning on like oral path, you get a break, and then you come back, and then maybe it's like dental materials and farm or something, and then you get a lunch, and then you go back for the afternoon for a few more classes, and they do that for 3 days. It's like every subject that is on boards, they tackle like subject by subject, so you know exactly what you need to know for each subject. Oh no, my page just came off. Okay, anyway, I remember like highlighting everything. I don't know if you can see my highlights. Highlighting like everything you need to know, and then making study guides off my highlights. I have study guides in here, I know I did. I remember typing out a bunch of study guides, like of the highlights that were difficult for me to remember. I wrote like for vital signs and stuff, like, oh my gosh, can you even see this? Vital ASA guidelines. I made study guides, y'all, off of this book. And now it doesn't have a cover because it was worked so hard. So anyway, they also gave you study tips and like relaxation tips and focusing tips and things that like really helped me, not only in the test, but I've actually like brought with me to work chairside. I know it may sound silly, like breathing techniques and relaxation techniques, but this is a very big test and it can be a very huge, big, stressful part of your life. Also, this course stays up to date, always in the know, with the most current, you know, information on guidelines. You all know what I'm talking about. Guidelines are always changing, ever changing. And I remember the year I took boards, it was during the should you or should you not have your patient take antibiotic pre-meds for if they had joint replacements. And I know different like vital signs and different numbers like slightly differ depending on what the most current researched, evidence-based research is telling us. I remember that being stressful for boards. Like, what do I need to know? The new guideline or the old guideline? But it wasn't stressful anymore after I took this course because they told you exactly which one you need to know. I remember feeling like I had clear, concise direction on what I needed to know. There's just so much information. I remember they include like a mock exam at the end. It's for you to take home. You didn't do it at the course. It was like a mock exam, like you logged in on the computer and they explained how to like properly take that so you can really feel like you're at boards taking it. I mean, I just keep going on and on. I know, I'm just so happy that I took this course. I feel it greatly prepared me, like I keep saying. So that's that. But yes, when I got home, I remember making study guides and I kind of like showed you them. Let me show you them again. I remember like breaking it down. Like there's 12 subjects. So I probably did like 2 subjects a week. I remember like, telling myself like, I need to do these subjects this week. And then like the last week I just like studied everything. And then I remember them teaching us to the night before you take boards to not study. Like the day before or the night before. And I remember they said to do something relaxing. And what I chose was to watch The Mask. Jim Carrey's The Mask, because that relaxed me. I'll never, every time I like hear like or see a meme about The Mask, I'm like automatically like, boards, but in a good way. So I studied really hard all the weeks going up to it. I remember the day before, I didn't feel like I needed to cram. I was like ready to go. Also for like difficult things I had to memorize, I think there's like fluoride charts or something, you know, like numbers that you have to memorize. I remember using like flashcardmaker.com. I used to use that all the time in my undergrad for like biology and chemistry, and flashcardmaker.com. It's probably like really aging me, or maybe it's still hip. I don't think so, probably not. There's probably something like you could talk to an app and it makes the flashcards for you. But what I liked is that you didn't have to physically write flashcards like note cards. I just typed them in and then I'll show it. I'll like show it right now. Oh, see, here are some of my old flashcards. That brings me back looking at that. So that's what I did. I studied this like a Bible. This is the new one that you would be studying as like a Bible. And I studied my notes. I made my flashcards. I memorized as much as I could, right? You need to memorize. But more importantly, I understood the concepts. I remember really trying to understand the concepts of like, right, like gingivitis and periodontal disease, all that. Like the concepts of everything was very important for me to, I felt like when it clicked. And I hope this video helped you. Please like and subscribe if it did. And if you are struggling right now and or stressing about boards, please know that you're not alone. It's a lot of hard work right now, but it's worth working hard right now so you can be soon in a career place that you love. Being a dental hygienist is an amazing, outstanding career where you truly get to help people all day and like make a difference. So I'm sending you all the positive toothy vibes that I have. Peace, love, and teeth. I wonder if they let you wear this at the board, you know, probably not. They'd be like, no, you're cheating.